A New Nation of Time by Jorge Luis Borges. Audiobook 1x2. A New Refutation of Time vor mir kein Zeit, noch mir Word kein Sinn. MIT mir Gebirt SIE sich, MIT mir Jet SIE auch ein. Be afore me there was no time, after me there will be none / with me it is born, with me it will also die. Daniel von Chipko, Sexenta Minidistica Sapientum 3, 2, 1655, preliminary note. Had this refutation, or its title, been published in the middle of the 18th century, it would be included in a bibliography by Hume, or at least mentioned by Huxley or Kemp Smith. But published in 1947, after Bergson, it is the anachronistic reductio ad absurdum of an obsolete system, or even worse, the feeble artifice of an Argentine adrift on a sea of metaphysics. Both conjectures are plausible and perhaps even true, but I cannot promise some startling new conclusion on the basis of my rudimentary dialectics. The thesis I shall expound is as old as Zeno's arrow or the chariot of the Greek king in the Melinda Panha. Its novelty, if any, consists in applying to my ends the classic instrument of Berkeley. Both he and his successor David Hume abound in paragraphs that contradict or exclude my thesis. Nonetheless, I believe I have deduced the inevitable consequence of their doctrine. The first article, A, was written in 1944 and appeared in number 115 of Sir. The second, from 1946, is a revision of the first. I have deliberately refrained from making the two into one, deciding that two similar texts could enhance the reader's comprehension of such an unwieldy subject. A word on the title. I am not unaware that it is an example of that Monday stir called a contradictionary in adjecto by logicians, for to say that a refutation of time is new, or old, for that matter, is to recognize a temporal predicate that restores the very notion the subject intends to destroy. But I shall let this fleeting joke stand to prove, at least, that I do not exaggerate the importance of wordplay. In any case, language is so saturated and animated by time that, quite possibly, not a single line in all these pages fails to require or invoke it. I dedicate these exercises to my ancestor Juan Cris 6 Tom Olafinur, 1797-1824. Who left a memorable poem or two to Argentine letters and who strove to reform the teaching of philosophy by refining out traces of the